Hello there, and welcome to TechNose. Today we're going to be installing Windows 95 on this Pentium 3. Now, why am I doing this? I don't know, because I need a video for this channel. But before we do that, there are some problems. First off, you may notice, this is a USB flash drive. This computer does not support USB booting, so that's going to be an issue. Yeah, this still needs a way to boot, so I'm going to make a plop disk. But we got to make it first, so I'm going to go ahead and turn it on.
You may notice that it's not plugged in. Well, it's because by default, this thing will turn on when it starts receiving power. It's like a power restore thing. Now you can turn that off in the BIOS, but the problem is this thing has a dead battery, so yeah, it's not gonna go well. Turn this on. It's probably gonna yell at me. This is gonna be stretched and horrible. Bam. Enter setup. It's because yeah. So that's right. Let's see if I can change the monitor so that it doesn't look like absolute stretched bullshit. Yeah, come on. Nah. No. Hope I got the remote. Nope. Go down. Picture size. Okay, oops. That one. Go down. Picture size. Two. Native. Oh. Oh, this is gonna be fun. Native resolution, look for me, don't scale it. Yeah. Just gonna have to. Oops. Zoom. Get it out of the angle so they can see it better. And now we need the time. I don't have a watch, so here we got all that fixed up. Let's boot into the operating system that this normally has on here. Sure, it is taking a while. Ah. So I don't want it to seek. Good for it. I'm gonna boot into Windows 2000. Screen resolution you can handle. That better screen resolution so that it's not just this big black border and everything. Hey, it booted! And wait, did it? Where's the icon? Oh, there we are. Man, this thing is slow.
I bet that hard drive's not doing too good.
Oh. Oh boy. Yeah, it's on. Oh, that's right, because I swapped the CD-ROM drive out because it wasn't working right. Okay. Oh, let me wait for it to do its thing. Meantime, let's open up Task Manager and see what we're dealing with. Really? All right. Da-da-da. Come on. Work. Work, damn you. All right, it's gonna be. Updates are ready for your computer. How did you find updates? You're not connected to the internet. Cancel. I'm gonna disable update. Turn off automatic updates. It's taking forever to install the CD-ROM drive. Load. Oh no. We've gone into draw mode. This is bad. Then bring it back. And oh no. Still doing this. Why? Oh. This is getting irritating.
Supposed to like. I think that hard drive is failing.
Yeah. You gotta be kidding me. Open my computer. God damn it. Go ahead and put on the put the disk in the drive. Oh, wait. I know. Hey. It did something? No. Let's... Hey, it's there. Let's open up Helpad. Hey, it's all in there. Nothing looks corrupted. Alright, well, let's restart and see if it works. Hey, that's a good sign. And it booted! Alright. Let's go to... Okay. USB! Gonna boot. Place the vicious beans. It's not even doing anything. It's not gonna boot. God damn it. What if I pull it? Oh, look. Nothing. You know what I forgot? I forgot Windows 95 is not bootable. I need DOS. Alright, well, step two. Get DOS. Alright. There we go. Let's load it up faster, thankfully. Come on. going at this again.
Now you're over this.
Why is it specifically my computer that causes problems? I think this is, it really hates that CD drive. It always unplugged it. But, I don't know, maybe later. Why is it taking this long? It's just my computer. Okay. There we go. Look how easy that was. Drag it down. I'll drag it to the down. Alright. Find an image. That's a dust. What the dust is. Gosh, is there anything on this button already? No, I addressed Marvel's final floppy disk. What? Okay. Well, I guess format it. Cannot format this media as write protected.
What? No, it's not.
Oh, I guess it is. Hello. So apparently this disc is bad. Let's find another one. This disc is any good. This is a Mavica disc. Okay.
This one's still sealed, so yeah, this, hopefully this will be okay. Golden retriever.
Would you like the force of the smelt on this volume?
Yes. Hey, went off without a hitch. There it is. Run Cubase. Let's get things started. Okay. Now, of course, to get something like this working, you gotta open it up. And since I don't want to overwrite that pre-existing drive, I'm gonna use another one I have in here. And look at all the goodies. Now you see the drive is right there. It's not plugged in at the moment, but there it is. And since I'm lazy and I don't want to deal with jumpers or anything, I'm just gonna steal this. Good. But first, we gotta get all the fun. We gotta get it prepared. So, let's get it plugged back in. Uh-oh. Let's see the drive. That's not good. All right, well, let's see. once out. Let's see what's wrong with this. Is there a jumper? Let's see. Jumper J20. Okay. Well.
I'm gonna need to use this as a magnifying.
Never mind. I'm just gonna leave it all dingle.
I'm not even gonna bother with the
mom at it.
So, power.
It's pretty tight in the last connector. Like my buckle.
Now, we plug it in and pray.
This way.
Hey, there it is. It's working. It works. Alright. Let's do some computer. Why can't I go down to the fence?
is.
Huh. Interesting.
Just getting some stuff my last piece of reads it just fine. What's the format? ISO 9660.
Okay, so.
Alright.
I'll meet you back when I go back into DOS. So, as you can see, DOS is, I've mounted the Windows 95 drive in, and I've also went ahead and disconnected the Windows NT drive just to make sure nothing bad happens. And yeah, we are in DOS.
Let's see, does it read C? It does. Does it read C well? It does. Alright. Let's get a setup. Alright. Here you go, scan this. Welcome to Windows 95 setup. Alright. Yes. Alright. Yeah, see Windows. Let's do custom. Yeah, include the games. Include the mouse pointers. Quick view. Yeah. Include the screensavers. Include the wallpaper. Don't need that. Communications. Good. Wi-Fi, multimedia, CD player, yes. All of that, all of this. Audio compression. Yeah. The Microsoft Network? No. Those messages? No. Okay, I think that should be good. User interface. Oh, I just forgot you could do this. You could use Progman on Windows in the phone. No, I don't understand. Okay. Well, this is gonna take a while, so. Right back. And would you look at that? All done. Set up the tape and just gonna be fun. Alright. Getting ready to run Windows 95 for the first time. It boots. That's a good sign. Wait, whoa. No, I don't want a printer. Hey, look at that. I'm sure it's gonna be dry for this. Hey, supports ACPI. Alright, well, let's get them drivers. Unfortunately, this means I'm gonna have to go back to Windows NT or Windows 1000. So, just gotta plug this thing back in. There you go.
Now it has power. Now I'll get this thing.
Whoa! It actually remembered? Oh, it's booting on the sci-fi. I didn't want that. Pop away.
There we go.
All right. There's nothing wrong with it. Just because it's been in Linux doesn't mean there's anything wrong with it.
Oh, it's done. Okay, now I got the drivers in the game. Let's boot back over to 175.
Windows NT partition is FAT32.
Alright. Software.
No. Don't.
Starting on the 75.
Okay. Something's happening. Okay.
Whoa.
Ooh.
So that means that was installed. Let's clear that settings.
Yeah, how far?
It's still a 1280.
1024 by 768.
No. Want to eat this? Yes.
Wait, is this a widescreen?
Nope.
Now that's fine. We'll go here. That is Intel.
It's got software. Audio drivers. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Oh, it's got a Google layer. That's it. That's it. Okay. And then you can set it. Gets on the desktop? Yes. Did not direct this. Alright. Yeah, before direct this. This is silly. Device. What is the sound system? Oh, so this is the support sound master? Whoa. try it anyway. I can hear it, but I can't see it. We're gonna have to install drivers and show DirectX. Yes, that it. Yes, reinstall DirectX. Let's get it started.
At least it starts up pretty quick. I don't even want stuff working.
Alright. See if Doom works now. Still can't see it. Strange. Look at random in the middle. You install DirectX. Successfully. So yes, I am. Roll there. Where? Yeah, it's working. Yes. Go again. Maybe you can reinstall and post it. Oh, it works. Must have just been the TV. Of course. Down there. Strange. Weird.
which was in higher resolution, but
yeah, Doom works absolutely fine. That is weird, what? Is it like repeating the sound? From I'm sorry, I'm just playing the game now. Lord. It works. But yeah. I think that should be... Thank you for watching and see you later.